Okay, so in previous lecture we have seen a simple overview of entire syllabus of special electrical machines. So syllabus total consists 6 modules. So from this particular lecture we are going to start our first module, which is a stepper motor and its control. Okay, so we are going to discuss this module number 1, that is stepper motor and its control. So in this particular module, first of all, I'm going to explain the introduction about stepper motor. What is stepper motor? What are the special constructional features which are there in stepper motor from other motors? Then we are going to discuss construction and working of 2 different types of stepper motor. First one is the variable reluctance motor, and second one is permanent magnet stepper motor. Okay. Then we will discuss the different application areas where we use that stepper motor widely. After that, we are going to discuss 2 characteristics of stepper motor. First one is the different characteristics of stepper motor and different control strategies, like open loop control and closed loop control. So that characteristics are actually static characteristics and dynamic characteristics of stepper motor. Then we will discuss different control strategies, that is power converter, control using power converter circuit and using a DSP or microcontroller based control. So if possible, if time permits, we will discuss 2 more types of stepper motor rather than this VR motor, that is variable reluctance motor, and permanent magnet stepper motor. Okay, if time permits, we will discuss another 2 types of stepper motor also. So there are certain numericals, very short numericals of there for 5 marks. That numericals are from calculation of step angles and calculation of resolution of a stepper motor. So we will discuss that particular numericals also during this particular chapter. So I will definitely try to complete this entire chapter within 7 to 8 lectures, because the maximum part is the theoretical part. Only you have to understand the construction, working, and actual control strategies. Okay. So let's start with this stepper motor. So what is a stepper motor? So especially name itself suggests it's stepper. So that means the motor which generally works in the steps, in the discrete angular steps, that particular motor is generally known as a stepper motor. So unlike a DC motor or maybe AC motors, the stepper motor will not run in continuous manner, but the running or working of that particular motor takes place in the discrete angular steps. So that means depending upon the pulse which is received for the particular winding which is present on stator, the motor will rotate in a certain step, either in certain degrees, maybe 15 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, or maybe 90 degrees. So this degree depends upon generally step angles. So stepper motor name itself suggests that the motor which runs or the motor which rotates in discrete angular steps, that particular motor is generally known as a stepper motor. So a stepper motor is a special electrical machine which rotates in a discrete angular steps in response to the program sequence of input electrical pulses. Okay, so according to the sequence signal or sequence input electrical signal, the motor will rotate in a steps. That means motor will rotate with certain degrees. So that particular motor is generally known as a stepper motor. So whenever we see certain applications in a day-to-day life, then we or certain question will get arises in our mind. That means, say suppose we take application of a robotic arm. So according to the requirement, that robotic arm will move with certain step, with certain degrees, and that will perform the particular desired applications. Suppose if we take example of certain conveyor system, let's say there is a process control plant or simple a bottle filling plant. Okay, so the empty bottles are placed over the conveyor, and that empty bottle comes or at the bottom side of that filling unit, and for a certain duration of time that empty bottle stay at that particular filling unit, then certain liquid will fill inside that bottle, and again that bottle will move in forward direction. So there is a stepwise movement of that conveyor. Whenever that particular each bottle came in, each bottle came below to that filling unit. So such type of process industry is also required certain stepwise movement. Or if we take simple example of our printer, okay, so in that particular printer again, there is a step-to-step movements are taking place. So that means simply if we place the print command from our computer, then according to the picture or according to the data which is available on the file, that particular data will get printed over the page using that printer. And again, that printer works in stepwise manner. Okay, so if we look towards that printer page, that page is shifts in certain stepwise manner. Okay, so that is again possible with the help of this stepper motor. So whenever such type of applications involves where we required a stepwise movement of a particular object, then in such particular application we generally use this stepper motor, because this motor rotates in a discrete angular steps, and these discrete angular steps have been achieved from the program sequence of input electrical signal. That means the windings which are present on stepper motor, that windings or stator winding is not continuously excited as similar to the DC motor or AC motor. Basically in AC motor or DC motor, we excite stator winding with a continuous supply. When we interrupt that supply, the motor will stop, or motor will comes to its standstill position. But such thing is not there in case of stepper motor. That means that windings have not been continuously excited with a electrical supply or with the electrical energy. But we excite a set of winding for a certain time in a sequential or in a program sequence manner. And according to that particular winding excitation, the motor will runs. Okay. Now this stepper motor is also known as a step motor or stepping motor. Okay, so in some literature we found the alternate name for this stepper motor as a step motor or stepping motor. Okay, now how this stepper motor will works? So stepper motor generally works on the principle of a magnetic interaction which taken place between the rotor and a stator. And according to that magnetic interaction, rotor will move. So there is a certain magnetic interaction, either attraction or repulsion takes place between rotor teeth and a stator teeth. And according to that magnetic interaction only, the motor will move. So the stepper motor generally works on this simple principle, that is the magnetic interaction between rotor and stator. Now, constructionally, when we look any stepper motor, then again, whatever stationary part is there, which term as a stator, and that stator consists a winding. So only winding is present on stator. On rotor, there is no any kind of winding or a permanent magnet. Okay. So the rotor of stepper motor does not consist any sort of winding, or that does not consist a permanent magnet when we talk about variable reluctance motor. Okay, so variable reluctance motor rotor does not consist any type of a winding, or it does not consist any permanent magnet, but that rotor is generally made up of a salient structure, and depending upon the step angle, we generally design the number of salient pole. I think you are familiar with this salient structure rotor. If we recall concept of salient pole synchronous machine, then that salient pole synchronous machine generally consists a salient structure rotor. Okay, so there are number of poles according to the requirement. So similar kind of rotor is present in case of variable reluctance stepper motor. Only difference is, in case of synchronous motor, there is a field winding present over that salient pole, but the variable reluctance stepper motor does not consist any winding on the salient pole rotor. So there is no any winding, as well as there is a no there may not have any permanent magnets present on rotor. So that will definitely makes the machine structure very robust and reliable, because as there is a no requirement of, or there is a no winding present on rotor, there is a complete elimination of a brush and slip ring arrangement. So that will, that makes motor as a robust motor, and as well as that motor is reliable. Therefore, this stepper motor is very popular in the applications where we require a stepwise movement of or stepwise rotation or rotation in some discrete angular steps. Okay. So at present, the automation systems requires control of a position or speed, or maybe both, at low cost. And for such particular application, the first choice is a stepper motor. Okay. So basically, when we talk about any automation system, so whatever example which I have given in this lecture itself, that is example of your robotic arm, or maybe example of a process control, a process plant where we control, simple example is conveyor system. So all that are generally automated systems. Okay. So all these automated systems where we require to control the position of actual mechanism, or that may be speed of particular mechanism, or in some cases both. So in such application, due to the low cost of this particular stepper motor and its robustness, the stepper motor is the first choice for these applications. Okay. So we can find application of stepper motor in various areas, ranging from small wristwatch to artificial satellites. So whatever wristwatch we use, so our whatever wristwatch is there, that wristwatch also consists certain stepper motors. So starting from that small wristwatch to some large satellite system also, this stepper motor has the diverse area of applications. Now, these stepper motors are generally available with a power range of 1 watt to 2.5 kilowatt and torque range of 1 micro newton meter to 40 newton meter. So these are generally available for low wattage, starting from 1 watt to the high watt value of 2.5 kilowatt. This is the power rating, and the torque rating is starting from 1 micro newton meter. So that is very low torque motors to a 40 newton meters. Okay, so now we are going to discuss the various types of stepper motor and its construction, working, and then we will proceed towards control strategy. So there are actually three different types of stepper motor. First one is the variable reluctance type motor, second one is the permanent magnet type motor, and third motor is a hybrid type stepper motor. Okay, so three types of stepper motors are available. First one is the variable reluctance, second one is permanent magnet type, and third one is hybrid type stepper motor. Okay. So in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss the first type of stepper motor, which is variable reluctance type stepper motor, or that is also abbreviated as VR stepper motor. Okay. Now, every stepper motor works on the principle of a magnetic interaction, that is interaction between the stator and rotor due to either magnetic force of attraction or repulsion. So when we talk about a variable reluctance stepper motor, this motor works on the principle that the magnetic material placed in magnetic field experiences a force, and that force is experienced by that material to align that material in the path of a minimum reluctance. So in basics of magnetism, you have learned these reluctance concepts. So always magnetic material tries to align itself in the magnetic field in the path of low reluctance, similar to say when we talk about electrical network, then generally current tries to flow through a path of low resistance. Similarly, in case of magnetic system, the whatever magnetic material is there, that magnetic material always try to align itself, or always experiences a forces to align itself in the path of a low reluctance. Now you are familiar with this concept of reluctance. I'm not going to re-explain that particular concept, what is reluctance and for which particular system reluctance is low and high. So this variable reluctance stepper motor consists a stator with a salient poles, which consist a concentric winding, which form different phases. So when we talk about construction of variable reluctance stepper motor, yeah, so this is the construction of variable reluctance stepper motor. So here the motor consists a stator. That stator has different salient poles and a concentric winding is wounded over this salient pole. Okay, so if you look towards this particular diagram, there are total 8 poles available on stator, and all that 8 pole consist a certain winding which are in concentric form. That windings are not distributed, but that windings are generally concentrated windings. Okay, now how these particular poles or windings have connected? The stator pages are excited by the current pulses to establish a magnetic field. Now how to connect this particular winding? So if you look towards this particular schematic diagram, the opposite pole windings are connected in series, and that winding pole is excited with a one particular supply. So here if you look this diagram, say this top pole and bottom pole winding, both windings which are indicated by red color, that winding is connected in series, and this winding is excited with a plus VDC and ground. Okay, that means with a DC supply. So here pole winding or winding which is present on this pole, top pole and bottom pole, this winding is generally excited with one supply. Similarly, for second case, the winding is indicated with a green color. This green color winding, that means simple opposite pole faces windings are connected in series, and that particular winding is excited with one particular supply. So that supply is shown with a green color over here. Similarly, third is yellow color winding and fourth one is black color winding. So if you look towards this particular stator, this stator consists total 8 poles. So 8 concentrated coils have been placed over this pole structure. These coils have been connected in such a way that opposite pole windings are connected in series and they are excited with a one supply. So here 4 poles, 8 poles are there. That means there are possible 4 series combinations of winding. So we excite this stator winding with 4 different voltage sources, that is 4 different DC voltages. Okay, and fifth one is the ground. Okay, so this is the construction for variable reluctance stepper motor for stator. So stator generally consists the salient poles, and that has concentric windings of different phases. So now whatever diagram which we have seen in that slide, that diagram is for 4 pole stepper motor. Actually 8 poles are there, so 8 pole, so 4 windings have been placed on that 8 poles in such a way that opposite poles consist a same phase winding. Okay, so there are, that particular motor is 4 phase motor, you can say, in simple. Okay, now that 4 phases have excited by current pulses, and whenever we excite that current phases with current pulses, definitely there will be formation of a magnetic field. So whenever we excite, actually one phase is excited at a one time, or maybe according to requirement of step angle, we excite 2 phases at a time. Okay, that means there are different excitation scheme. We are going to study that in our succeeding lectures. So maybe 2-1-1-2 excitation scheme, maybe 2-2 excitation scheme, 1-1 excitation scheme. So we will discuss that particular excitation scheme in our next lecture. So the windings, each winding is excited for a certain period of time. After that, that winding is disconnected and its adjacent winding or next winding is excited. Okay, so accordingly, whenever we excite any stator winding with the help of DC supply, there will be formation of a magnetic field. Now that is for the stator structure. What is there for rotor? So when we consider rotor, then rotor is generally the salient structure with a projecting teeth and has no windings or permanent magnet. So if you look towards this rotor, then rotor is here a salient pole rotor with a number of teeth. So how many teeth are there? There are total 6 teeth present on this rotor periphery. Now this rotor does not consist any permanent magnet or any winding. So this is a simple structure which is made up of a laminated ferromagnetic material. So this rotor is again laminated rotor with a ferromagnetic material that consists number of teeth and salient pole structure. Now how many number of teeth should be present over this rotor? So the number of teeth which are there on rotor, that depends upon the requirement of a step angle. By how much angle we have to run that particular motor, or by how much step angle that motor should run, whether we have to run that motor for 30 degree angle, 45 degree angle, 90 degree angle, 60 degree angle, or maybe 1.5 degree angle, okay, or maybe 1/8 of 1.5, 1/8 times 1.5. So depending upon that, we are going to study how to calculate that step size or step angle, okay, in numericals or in actual characteristics, and then we will solve some numericals, okay. So the number of teeth basically depends upon the step angle required. So according to the requirement of step angle, that means by how much degree we have to rotate that particular motor for one step. तो कितने डिग्री से वो मोटर हर स्टेप में रोटेट होना चाहिए, तो उसके ऊपर उसके नंबर ऑफ टीथ डिपेंड करेंगे. ओके, सो नंबर ऑफ टीथ जनरली डिपेंड्स अपॉन दैट फैक्टर. ओके, सो व्हेन वी लुक टुवर्ड्स द रोटर स्ट्रक्चर, इट इज अ सैलिएंट पोल स्ट्रक्चर विदाउट एनी वाइंडिंग और परमानेंट मैग्नेट. दिस एंटायर स्टेटर एंड रोटर बोथ स्ट्रक्चर्स आर लैमिनेटेड स्ट्रक्चर. सो दैट आइडिया विल क्लियर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फिगर. सो इफ यू लुक टुवर्ड्स, दिस इज एक्चुअल cross-sectional view of a stepper motor. Okay, so this is the stator, whatever silver color portion is there, this is the stator structure, and this stator is again laminated structure. So if you look towards stator, that is laminated with a number of poles. Okay, and that poles consist of winding, and this is the rotor. So rotor also has the number of teeth. Okay, so these both are the rotor sections which consist a number of teeth, and there is a permanent magnet present because this rotor motor is permanent magnet stepper motor. Okay, then bearing, shaft, front end cap, back end cap, or rear end cap, so that are different constructional components which are present in stepper motor. Okay, so that is for the construction. So construction is simple. Stator is laminated structure with salient pole. That stator generally consists even number of poles. Every pole carries certain concentrated winding. Opposite side pole windings are connected in series, and that is excited with a different phases. Rotor is generally salient pole rotor with number of teeth on rotor surface. Number of teeth basically depends upon the step size required, and there is no any winding or permanent magnet present on rotor for variable reluctance type stepper motor. Now again, there are two different types of variable stepper motor, variable reluctance stepper motor, that are single stack stepper motor and multi stack stepper motor. Okay, so let us try to understand the construction and working of a single stack variable reluctance stepper motor. Okay, so this is the cross sectional view of a single stack variable reluctance stepper motor. So as I have already told, the stator of this variable single stack variable reluctance stepper motor consists different number of projections, different number of salient poles. So these are the stator teeth or stator poles. So number of salient poles are generally even. Okay, so that may be 6 pole, 8 pole, 10 pole or more. So the stator of single stack variable reluctance stepper motor is made up of silicon steel lamination. It has projecting poles with usually even number. These poles carries a concentrated winding. So if you look towards the stator, now you will find a winding which is marked with a circular portion. So these are, this is the winding. So a concentrated winding is placed over the stator pole. Now in stator with even number of poles, the windings on opposite poles are connected in series such that currents in that winding establish a magnetic flux on each side, on aid of each side. Okay. So if you look this construction, this is stator with 8 poles. So 8 poles. So we wound these 8 concentrated coils over these 8 poles. Opposite side coils are connected in series so that that can be excited with a one phase. So here A and A dash, that windings are connected in series and that is excited with a DC supply. Similarly, B and B dash, that opposite windings connected in series. Similarly, we connect CC dash and DD dash. So if you look this switching circuit, winding A and A dash, these windings are connected in series. Here, winding A, A dash connected in series. Similarly, we connect winding B, B dash in series, C, C dash in series, and D dash in series. So that 4 coils are connected in series. So opposite side coils are connected in series. Now, in every winding circuit, there is a semiconductor switch. Either this switch is a triac, this is actually a thyristor, or maybe any other semiconductor controlled switch is there. Okay, controlled semiconductor switch. So in series with each phase winding, there is a controlled switch. And according to the sequence of opening and closing of this switch, we can excite every winding for a particular time. Okay, so this is actually 4 phases, 8-pole single stack VR stepper motor, 4 phases, because 4 windings are there, A, B, C, D. So that are excited with 4 separate DC, actually 1 DC, but 4 separate DC paths. So 4 phases and 8 poles. 8 poles, the stator consists total 8 number of poles. Therefore, this is 4 phases, 8-pole single stack variable reluctance stepper motor. Okay. So that is for stator. Now what is rotor? Rotor is usually laminated silicon steel. Rotor, if you look towards this rotor structure, it is a laminated silicon steel rotor. Now, solid silicon steel is also used for rotor core, but practically to reduce this rotor is made up of also lamination. In some small motors, this entire rotor structure is a solid silicon steel also. Okay, that means entire rotor is a solid structure, but in large motors generally that structure is laminated. Okay, now which material is used to form this or to construct this stator and rotor core? So we generally use the magnetic material which has higher permeability. So the material with a high permeability is generally used for a stator and rotor. Now, as I have already explained, rotor consists a number of projecting teeth on its outer fairing without any winding and permanent magnet. Now, how many the rotor teeth are there? So generally, the number of rotor teeth and stator poles are not equal. And this is made to motor self-starting and also to have a bi-directional rotation of a rotor. So we generally keep unequal number of rotor and stator teeth. And if that teeth are unequal, then self-starting feature and bi-directional rotation of a motor can be achieved. If these both teeth are equal, under this particular case, there is a magnetic locking of these teeth for between winding takes place, or magnetic locking of stator teeth and rotor teeth will take place, and that will not make that motor as a self-starting. So to make self-starting stepper motor, basically number of teeth on stator core and rotor, that number of teeth are not same. So for this particular example, we consider total 6 rotor teeth on a rotor periphery. So rotor consists total 6 rotor teeth. There are total 8 stator teeth and 6 rotor teeth. So this is the switching circuit for this particular case. So as I have already explained, A and A dash winding, that is winding present on these two poles, are connected in series, and to X flow or to control the flow of current through this winding, we use one semiconductor switch in series with A dash. Similar kind of connection is there for phase B winding, phase C winding, and phase D winding, and these entire windings have been excited with a DC supply. So this is for four pole, four phases, eight pole, single stack, variable reluctance stepper motor. Have you understood construction? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay. Sir. Yeah. Now let's come back towards working of this stepper motor. How this particular motor will run in a steps or with a certain degree. So let us consider rotor teeth are at any position until stator winding is energized. So whenever there is a no current flowing through stator winding phases, we assume that rotor teeth is at any position. For a simplicity, let us consider initial position of rotor is as shown in figure 1.1. So this will be the initial position of a rotor. Initial position of a rotor whenever there is a no any excitation provided to stator, means all four switches are in open condition. Okay. So if you look towards this particular position, now the pole 2 of this rotor is aligned with B winding, and pole 5 is also aligned with B. So 2 and 5, these both poles have been aligned in B winding. Now why this 6 pole construction is generally utilized? For 6 pole construction, basically there is a only one pair of a rotor pole is in alignment with a stator pole. Here, if you look towards the alignment, only one pair is let in aligned with a stator pole. Okay, when there are two different pole aligns with stator pole, then definitely that motor will not a self starting, and that is possible when this rotor consists total 4 or maybe 8 number of rotor teeth. But basically in practical applications, whenever we design any stepper motor, the number of or the difference between rotor and stator poles are kept to be 2. Okay, so there is a difference between rotor teeth and stator teeth, and that difference is generally 2. Okay, so dono mein do ka difference hona chahiye practical design ke waqt. Okay, I will explain why this is so. So here, whenever our stator winding is not excited with any supply, then the initial position of rotor is shown as shown in this figure 1.1. All four switches are in open condition. Now let's suppose we turn on switch S1. Okay, let we turn on this switch S1. What will happen when we turn on this switch S1? Now this winding A and A dash will carry current, which is excited with a DC supply. So whenever the winding A and A dash will carry its current, there is a formation of a magnetic field in that winding, so that say on A pole, N pole will form, and on its opposite pole there will be formation of a south pole, and that is actually achieved by connecting this winding or adjusting current flowing through that winding. You are familiar with this, how we achieve alternate poles on alternate magnetic poles on alternate physical poles. Okay, that is similar to your DC machine. So here, when we turn on switch S1, phase A is energized, and this will make stator pole A and A dash as north pole and south magnetic pole. Now what will happen whenever these stator poles are made with north and south at this particular case? Now there is a force of attraction takes place between rotor and stator. So the stator pole attracts rotor teeth, and rotor moves to occupy a position of a minimum reluctance. Okay, so rotor generally moves to occupy the position of a minimum reluctance, and due to this, now rotor will rotates with certain angle. Therefore the rotor teeth 1 and 4 take the rest position as shown in figure 1.3. yeah, so this is, so now here when we excite phase A, now the minimum reluctance path is now along with the phase A only, because that phase A is excited. So under this particular case, now rotor teeth 1 and 4 get in alignment with this stator pole A and A dash. Okay, so that is your rotor position when we excite phase A. Now let's say switch S2 is turned on and S1 is turned off. Now in second case, what we do? So after some time, whenever it is necessary to move that particular rotor, we switch on this switch S2 by turning off this switch S1. So when we switch on this switch S2, now winding B and B dash get excited. Okay, so under this case, winding B and B dash get excited. So when we switch on switch S2 by turning S1 off, the phase A or winding of phase A get de-energized, and that will excite winding of phase B. So as definitely stator poles B and B dash get energized, stator pole B and B dash get energized. As stator pole B and B dash get energized, there will be definitely rotor will try to move in a such direction to occupy the minimum reluctance path by traveling a minimum angular distance. Okay, this is important. Actually, rotor always takes a minimum reluctance path by traveling minimum distance, minimum angular distance. Therefore, when B and B dash get energized, the rotor will runs or rotates in counterclockwise direction or in anticlockwise direction, so that rotor pole 2 and 5 are get in alignment with B and B dash. So this particular position of rotor is shown in this figure 1.4. So here the rotor will rotates with a 15 degree, so that 2 and 5, that winding came in alignment with B and B dash. Okay, so rotor rotates by a 15 degree in counterclockwise direction or by anticlockwise direction, and under this particular case, as the 2 and 5 rotor teeth are came in alignment with B and B dash, magnetic locking takes place and rotor stay in a stationary position. Okay, that rotor rests at that particular equilibrium position. Okay, now what is angle of movement? Angle is 15 degree. How we calculate generally this angle, I will explain later. Okay, so rotor moves with a 15 degree. So how to calculate this angle? So the angle is calculated, which is actually known as a step angle. So this step angle is generally calculated by formula 360 degree divided by M into NR. So what is this M? M is the number of stator phases. M is the number of stator phases, and NR is the number of rotor teeth. So for this particular case, M is equal to 4, because motor is a four phase, 8 poles. 8 poles are actually stator poles. Okay, but how many rotor teeth are there? There are total 6 rotor teeth. So the motor is 4-phase motor. So 4-phase motor. So M is equal to 4. The number of teeth on stator rotor is equal to 6. Therefore, NR is equal to 6. So if you calculate the step angle is equal to 360 divided by 4 into 6. That comes to be 15 degree. Therefore, after excitation of a phase B, when B coil get energized and A coil get de-energized, the motor will runs with a 15 degree, so that rotor pole 2 and 5 align in minimum reluctance path under B and B dash in counterclockwise direction. Okay, now what is next sequence? Now we have to turn off S2 and we have to turn on S3. That is the next sequence. That means now we energize winding C or phase C by de-energizing phase B. So under this particular case, when C coil get energized, so this is actually now position. actual rotor position when we excite B phase. Now when we excite phase C, under this particular case, now coil C get energized. Coil C get energized and B get de-energized. So under this case, rotor again moves with a 15 degree so that now rotor teeth 3 and rotor teeth 6, that two teeth came in alignment with C and C dash, which is shown in figure 1.5. So here, so rotor now moves by next 15 degrees so that 3 and 6 came in alignment with C, C dash. Okay. Similarly, we turn on switch S4 by turning off switch S3. So when we turn off switch S3, phase C get de-energized. When we turn on switch S4, phase D get energized. So under this particular case, phase D get energized. So now rotor again moves in counterclockwise direction by 15 degree so that rotor teeth 4 and 1 came in alignment with D and D dash as shown in figure 1.6. Okay, so there is a now again 15 degree movement of rotor. So now from first rest position, rotor moves by 45 degree. Okay, so this is, in this way we can achieve this switching sequence. So this continues this operation by achieving this switching sequence, like S1, S2, S3, S4, again S1, S2, S3, S4, and after each switching, rotor moves by 15 degree. So there is a stepwise movement of rotor takes place with a 15 degree. So if we draw that truth table for the switching sequence, then we can draw this truth table with switch S1, S2, S3, S4 and the step movement. Then when switch S1 is on, initially motor is at rest position. When we turn off switch S1 and when we on switch S2, motor rotates by counterclockwise direction with 15 degree. When we follow third switching, that means when we turn off S2, when we turn on S1, motor will rotates by next 15 degree. So it's from initial rest position, motor now move in counterclockwise direction by 30 degree. Next sequence is again we have to turn off S3, turn on S4. Okay, under this case motor will move by 15 degree in counterclockwise direction. After that we are going to turn off switch S4 and we are going to turn on switch S1. Motor again runs by 15 degree so that after one complete switching cycle, motor will attain 60 degree from its initial rest position. Okay, so in this way, we are going to continue this switching sequence S1, S2, S3, S4, S1, S2, S3, S4, S1, S2, S3, S4, so that motor will move in 15 degree anticlockwise direction after each switching. Now, if we have to reverse the direction of rotation, so how to reverse that particular direction? So the direction of rotation can be reversed by reversing switching sequence. That means if say S1, S2, S3, S4 rotates motor in counterclockwise direction, if you have to reverse the direction, switching sequence should be S1, S4, S3, S2, S1. That means reverse switching sequence. Under this particular case, motor will rotate in counterclockwise direction. Okay, so this is about the working of variable reluctance stepper motor. Have you understood this?
Yes.
Okay, so in next lecture we will discuss this mode of excitation which I have introduced in this particular lecture, that is two phase on mode with a switching sequence 2-1-2-1 and so on. So we will discuss that particular mode in next lecture. Okay, so see, whatever things which I have explained, so that things we can see in this video. Yeah, okay, so this is a stepper motor. Say how many poles are there? There are total four poles. Okay, four stator poles, one say S1, S2, S3 and S4. Now rotor is, for sake of simplicity only, two pole rotor is shown over here. So rotor is two pole rotor, stator poles are S1, S2, S3 and S4. Now we are going to energize this particular stator pole with a different phases. So now this particular motor is two-phase motor. Okay, when we energize S1, under this case, N pole is in contact with or is in alignment with S1. When we energize next coil, say S2, okay, at this particular moment, rotor will runs rotates in 90 degree. Same sequence we are going to obtain when we energize next coil and so on. So when S2 is turned off, S3 is energized, rotor moves in next 90 degree and so on. So in this way, we can achieve the stepwise movement of a motor by energizing these particular switches in different fashion. So S1, S2, S3 and S4. Now these switches are generally, general switches are actually thyristors or SCRs, okay? So in this way, variable reluctance motor will work. So